New details emerge on an avalanche that killed a snowmobiler east of Breckenridge yesterday. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News. The Summit County coroner has identified the man killed in a local avalanche yesterday as Fritz Boehm, a former Breckenridge resident who lived in Sedalia. Boehm triggered a slide that ran 800 feet wide and 2,000 vertical feet. The CAIC released a preliminary report on the incident, showing he and his partner were riding on Glacier Peak, east of Breckenridge, near Georgia Pass. The north-facing slope slid around 11:30 a.m. Boehm's body was recovered by an avalanche dog around 12:30. He was deceased and under 4 feet of snow. Cause of death was suffocation. By now, skiers and snowboarders at the annual A-Basin Enduro are exactly halfway finished with their 10-hour ski marathon. On the start line at 7 a.m. this morning, there were first-timers and second-timers, and then there were old-timers, like Deadhead Ed. He's been doing this all 29 years of the Enduro and plans on at least 50 laps today, even with gnarly arthritis in his ankle.
I got a little arthritis going on in my left foot, and we'll see how that goes. It doesn't hurt. We'll just see if I can shove it in a boot today.
Another old-timer is Kurt Kaiser, a local doing the Enduro for his 21st year. Here's what brings him back season after season.
Sometimes it's the crew of people skiing that makes it wild.
The A-Basin Enduro ends today at 5 p.m., and then it's on to the after party at the A-Frame. That is open to the public with food and live music. A local 13-year-old took second overall at USASA Nationals in Copper this past week. The Summit Daily reports that Fynn Bullock-Womble took second for the Breaker Boys division behind Australia's Valentino Gaselli. Bullock-Womble won the Breaker Slopestyle event and took second in Halfpipe. Bullock-Womble is originally from North Carolina and rides for ski and snowboard club Vail. He now lives and trains year-round at Copper Mountain. If you're heading into the backcountry today, avalanche danger in Summit and Eagle counties is considerable at and below treeline. Forecasters predict this will be the warmest day of the year so far. You have three problems: loose wet at all elevations and aspects, wind slab on north through southeast aspects, and deep persistent on northeast through southeast aspects. CAIC says the slide that killed a snowmobiler near Breckenridge was on a north aspect and nearly broke to the ground. In sports, the Rockies lost to the Padres last night, 2-5. The Rockies and Padres finished their series today, starting at 1:10 p.m. Tonight, the Nuggets play a do-or-die game against the Minnesota Timberwolves. Winner gets a trip to the NBA playoffs. In local sports, Summit High Girls Soccer lost to Battle Mountain yesterday, 2-3. Baseball plays Eagle Valley today in Gypsum, and girls lacrosse plays Aspen at home. And this weekend, the Breckenridge Vipers are back on the ice for a winner-takes-all two-game series against the Vail Yeti in Vail. First game is Friday here in Breckenridge at Stephen C. West Ice Arena. Phil Lindemann, Krystal, 93 News.